start?
The FitzMagic nickname started, I think, with Coach Hartley one day. Obviously, got it from Ryan FitzPatrick, who I claim as my uncle sometimes, and some people believe me. But Coach Hartley started it, and Coach Coley carried it on during a practice or something. When I made a grab, I stuck on my hand and just prayed that the ball would stick, and it stuck. So from there, he's been calling me FitzPatrick.
You sound like you're not sure whether it's justified or not. You think it's justified?
No, it's justified.
Yeah.
What did you take out of the Vanderbilt game?
I think there was a bunch of takeaways, positive takeaways. I saw us running the ball really well. I saw each position group, the leader stepping up, and we did what we were supposed to do. We came out strong. We could have continued throughout the second half, kind of stopped on a few third and fourth downs, but there's a lot of takeaways. We just have to improve on that. We are working on them this practice.
We hear that the tight end is a tough position because you guys have to know what everybody's doing. Just how complex was what Vanderbilt was doing with their fronts? How challenging was that for Jake to get everybody in the right play and in the right protections?
I'd say for Jake it was easy because Jake's a genius with that stuff. But for me, just being my first time, it was a little bit more challenging. So just spending more time in the film room, just watching extra film as much as I can, seeing where they spike in or out and stuff like that.
What are you looking forward to most coming back to Sanford Stadium for the first game?
Probably just running out there. It's been a year, so just running out there, seeing all the fans, being able to put up a good performance for all the Dog fans that come out every single day. I mean, they try to go up to Vanderbilt, and now we get to play all the fans, 93,000, so it's exciting.
So a lot of times when you're working with the offense, so what's something unique about us
as a unit? As Stetson Bennett, and he's a baller. He can move. He can throw the ball well. It's fun playing with him because he loves the tight ends. Just as much as Jake does. They always favor the tight ends, it seems like. So it's fun.
So does he have a crazy memory or something of him out there in practice?
I'd say just there's been countless memories of him throwing the ball over the middle, trusting me, trusting Mole, trusting Charlie, instead of throwing it to the wide receiver. And I always love that about him. He'll just throw it up for a tight end and he says we have to go make a play on you. So.
You play some special teams too. What special teams units are you on?
I'm on field goal right now.
Field goal's one year. Tight ends are interesting. There were three y'all that went to Vanderbilt. Obviously, you have more tight ends than that. I assume they'll get a chance maybe to get some work. What can you tell you about the other guys working in your group? Goody, Brett,
Peyton Marsh, Kobe Wyatt, Mitchell Lawrence. They're all playing really well right now. They're competing every day. Like last year, it was similar for me. From Jackson and Isaac and all them, and now I feel like I can help them, teach them. So they're coming in, I'm meeting with them, talking to them about certain routes, certain blocks, how to take certain steps on blocks, and I feel like I'm helping them a lot.
Kirby was saying yesterday about the time that you had on us out team, how that was beneficial on your end. What type of things do you remember from that experience?
From scout team, there was so many memories. Lined up against Led or D-Walk, and sometimes at tackle. I'd say for a couple of weeks I was at tackle, right tackle. But just learning how to pass set, learning how to run block and stuff like that. The more physical aspect of football. And then from the route running aspect, just running against D-Bake and all the good linebackers that we've had. Just learned so much last year.
How easy is the buy-in for that, I guess? I mean, is it kind of a thing where you're like, oh man, I already want scout team, like, in the game, in the rotation, or not?
I feel like you can take two approaches. Like you said, you could say, oh man, I'm on scout team, or you can take the other approach where you buy in and say, this is all for the team, which is what I tried to do. And if I'm going in at my hardest every single day, that's going to make the linebackers, the safeties, the defensive linemen better. So.
Can you see where working at Kirby mentioned you played some tackle for a while because they were low on numbers. Do you think that actually helped you in your pass protection?
I definitely think. I mean, if you're going against DeAndre Walker every single day and coming full speed at you, eventually you're going to get better. So I think just doing that every single day, I probably did that for 4 or 5 weeks. And I'd say the first week I was like, oh man, right tackle, I hope they don't switch me to full-time right tackle. But I started to buy in, and it definitely ended with pass sets.
I was going to ask you, did you ever worry someone, hey, they're trying to make a tackle out of me?
Actually, one time, Kirby showed a clip in a team meeting, and he was like, don't get too good at this. And so I didn't want to get too good at it.
Going back to Scott's team, like in terms of Kirby's approach to it, though, I mean, is that something when other coaches were pretty from high school, is that something that did they ever mention in terms of how you might start out there? Is this kind of approach unique in terms of how he brings scholarship back and Scott team in place in there and trusts that experience?
I don't necessarily, Kirby mentioned, okay, you're going to be on this. I think it is kind of indicative of where you're going to be. And after that, they'll kind of decide where you're going to be. And then you're faced with, am I going to buy in or am I going to kind of mess around? Am I going to lock in for the defense? So,
How's Wolf fit in? When he came out here, he seemed kind of short to the point. I mean, is he kind of loosened up with you guys yet? How does that room work?
I live with Eli, and he's a funny dude. On the football field, he's fast, obviously, he's strong, he's quick. But off the field, he's a funny guy, and he's one of my best buddies.
Who's the quarterbacks having confidence in the tight ends in practice? How do you expect that to translate to the field the rest of the season?
I think if we run our routes the right way, if we run the right depth and everything, then they're going to get us the ball. They have a certain read. So.
John, can you talk about how that competition works? I mean, your roommate's with a guy that you compete with. I mean, how does that work at Georgia as far as competitors on the field, friends off the field? How would you explain that?
I'd say both Eli and I and Charlie are competing to push each other, and not necessarily I'm competing against him. There's no individual aspect of it. It's just all for the team, and that's what I like about this place. If you go to any position group, you're going to see that no one's against one another. And he's pushing me. He's telling me what to do on a certain play, and I can help him on a certain play and stuff like that. So.
Harley, what's the most unique thing about him? Because he seems like a different guy. He seems like a fiery ball.
Yeah, he is a fiery ball. The most unique thing about him is when after practice, when we call it up, and then we'll go into little position group call-ups, and you'll see him on the other side of the field, 100 yards away, after a sweaty day of practice, and we have to go sprint around, and he starts running around the field, and we got to chase him down. So that's probably the most unique thing.
Going back to quarterbacks, Nathan Priestley being the third string guy, I got it. Not really know about Kirby was saying a couple weeks ago about how useful of an asset he is to the offense.
He's definitely coming here. He came in early July.
Yeah.
He's learned the playbook really fast. He throws the ball well. He moves well. He's making checks at the line, so he's right there with all the other quarterbacks. He's doing a great job.